Hi, welcome back to Liquid Audio in Perth, Western Australia. Liquid Audio cherishing classic audio. This is Mike, and we're looking at a Musical Fidelity M1 DAC that I'm about to completely upgrade. It's an overhaul slash upgrade. It's an M1 by Musical Fidelity. That's the back panel there. You can see all the ins and outs there. And this is the main board removed from the main chassis. Or from the chassis, I should say. This is the main board, and on it you'll see everything is located on the one board, including the power supply and the DAC and output buffer. And here we're looking at the power supply, and there you can see just above it the DAC. But on the power supply we've got some input stuff there, some input filtering, transformer, some rectification. We're going to replace all of these capacitors. These are actually Jamicons. They're a good grade of Jamicon, these ones, but we're going to replace them with premium parts, and I'm going to replace the X-rated, the X2 cap there on the input across active and neutral. We'll go through, and then here on the DAC and output buffer, there's a bunch of stuff that we'll do here. That's a DSD 1796, a very good DAC chip, still manufactured by Burr Brown TI, but we'll change all of the caps around here, especially everything associated with critical signal stuff, like all of those caps around the DAC, around the sample rate converter that you can see, around that quad op amp, around those two output buffer op amps, and then we'll also change those output coupling caps. Those are very, very generic low-grade Jamicons. We'll put in some nice Nishicon Muse. And, you know, really everywhere we can, this is a project for myself just to see what can be done. And, you know, then if the results are good, I'll implement these upgrades for my customers if they should so wish. So you can see the main board there, and let's get going. Okay, so I have just finished working on this M1 DAC. This is a series of mods that I've come up with really for this unit to try, and here you can see just how many parts I've changed. This has taken hours. I mean, there's literally about 30 of these little electrolytic caps here, and another sort of 20 or 30 ceramics, which I've replaced with films, and there was an X2 rated cap, which was dead. That's really interesting. That measured 100 puff. It's not meant to be 100 puff. It's meant to be like 100 nanofarads. So yeah, there's a problem there. And replace the other electrolytics, the power supply ones, which were actually quite reasonable quality Jamicons. They were good Jamicons. All of these are just you know, crappy grade Jamicons. So here's the board. I'll try and remove some of that glare. And if we start over at the power supply, here's the mains inlet. Changed the X-rated cap across active and neutral. The big two filter caps there. Gives you a better view, doesn't it? And then you can see the other electrolytics all the way through here, and these filter caps as well. So yeah, you know, lots of nice high grade caps, BC, Panasonic. And then the other thing I've done, I've literally pulled out, the only bit I haven't worked on, I should say this, I haven't done anything with the USB input except change those electrolytics for Elner Silmic and Nishicon Fine Gold. I've left all the ceramics for now. I just cannot be bothered, and I've run out of the little 100 nanofarad, the tiniest 100 nanofarad caps that I need. So I can't do that at this point, so I'm going to leave that. But you can see everywhere else, I've used these Weimers to decouple. I haven't changed the ceramic to earth or ceramic to chassis. I haven't changed those. I've just left those. But all of these other ceramics, you can see I've replaced them with lovely Weimers. And especially important around the DAC, around the sample rate converter here, around the DAC, we've got Silmics. So beautiful Elner Silmic 2s. And Nishicon Fine Golds in the slightly less critical areas, and some very, very robust Panasonic FR there, right at the regulator outputs. So obviously I've used caps according to, you know, the function that they're performing and where they are. And then down towards the end here, you can see we've got some, again, some Weimers around this quad op amp. And then these are Kemet. These were the most expensive of this size that I had, so I saved them for the very end, right at the output there, right at those drivers that drive the output stage, or drive the actual outputs direct to the jacks. Now the other thing I've done, I've replaced the standard Jamicon bipolar output couplers with some Muse bipolars, which are quite nice. They're certainly a lot better than the Jamicons. And the other thing I've done on the bottom, we've decoupled each of those Muse, we've bypassed each of those Muse caps with a Weimer polyprobe. And of course, polyprobe is a really nice way to go. So yeah, that gives you a sort of an overview of the changes that I've made. Now, I've really just done this as an exercise out of curiosity, because I wanted to see just how good we could get this little M1 DAC sounding. The layout is really, really nice. I really like how they've designed this. I'm not particularly interested in the USB input, but you know, everything else here is great. It's beautifully symmetrical and beautifully laid out, and you know, there's lots and lots of local decoupling, bypassing. It's just really, you know, nicely thought out, typical of MF. You know, it's a good quality board as well. The only thing I've got to do is just take a few fingerprints off the top side, and I've got to just clean the bottom. I just need to deflux that. And yeah, then we'll pop it all back in. And very quickly, here is the board after a bit of a defluxing outside. And it's come up pretty well. I mean, it's not perfect, but it's a lot cleaner. There's a tiny little bit of residue on there, but this is non-critical. Yeah, so that's come up well. Another quick look. And for anyone following along, you may have noticed that I had missed one of the caps. It's the little one right here. I had left that out, so I've just gone and soldered that in. Luckily, I had literally one of these Weimers left. I just had one. And so that's perfect. So I've used my entire stock of these tiniest 5mm lead spacing film caps, all used in this job. And I'm going to put this board now back into the chassis, and then I'm going to hook it up and have a listen. And fingers crossed, she's going to sound good. And sorry, just one thing I wanted to mention, back to my very messy workstation here. I'm sorry about that. Need to clean up. Before I put the board back in, I just wanted to make mention of the fact that, look, whatever you might think of musical fidelity, especially now that things have sort of gone a little bit down the gurgler, but from this era, they made really good quality gear. I wanted to point out just how solid this chassis is. I mean, it's not solid like my TriVista DAC, but jeepers, this is a low-ish end DAC. It's not expensive. And my goodness, this thing is heavy. This thing is really heavy for its size. It's got a beautiful, thick aluminium front panel. The whole chassis is beautifully put together. The board unit, as I've been pointing out, is really, really nice. Lovely board. Great attention to detail. It's the areas where they've kind of cheaped out a little bit are in the connectors and things like that. There's some fairly low grade connectors and stuff on the back of this, you know, which is a little bit of a bummer, but. But really, overall, if you can get one of these things for just a few $100, you're doing very, very well. You're getting a really good DAC with a very high-grade DAC chip. That's the DSD-1796. Now, that's the... It's not quite as good as the DSD-1792 that's in the TriVista, but it's very, very good. The specs are very close. Have a look at the data sheet for confirmation there. The specs are remarkably close. So, this is a great value DAC. If you're looking for a DAC that's not expensive, that has, you know, pretty stellar performance. And I'm telling you this, no matter what you might read on forums, you get all the fanboys for the different brands, and you get all of the so-called experts who don't actually work on any of this gear, of course, for a living. They just have opinions. But I can tell you, having looked at lots of gear and having looked at this, that this is a very nice piece of gear for very sensible money. You're getting a lot for your cash with one of these. So this is a Musical Fidelity M1 upsampling DAC. Be back when I'm done. Welcome back. Here we are with the Musical Fidelity M1 DAC reassembled, back in the system, obviously in this case being fed by the Meridian 506 as a transport, and all of that you can see sitting atop my beloved TriVista itself, heavily modified. But yeah, the M1, look, it sounds amazing. These improvements that I've made to it have made a big, big difference. Most noticeably in the bass, it has stupendous bass performance now. Really a very dramatic improvement, and there's more air. It's more musical sounding now. So really, really worthwhile improvements. I mean, it took me a long time. I've got to say, it was a very tedious process to do it, and you know, spent hours today just desoldering and then soldering and goodness me. But anyway, look, probably well worth it. I'm not sure what I'll do with this. I'll either keep it for myself and just use it, or I might put it up on my website for sale. If anyone's interested, perhaps let me know. But yeah, lovely piece, and sounds just sublime. So that's the Musical Fidelity M1, heavily modified here by Liquid Audio in Perth, Western Australia. Thanks for watching.